All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back once again here to Room on Fire. We have the SLTV Starseries Season 10 coming up here. It's Titan versus Virtus Pro. Best of one game. And let me quickly see if I can figure out what all this nonsense is. Semler and Mendetta.
Oh.
Oh my god, it worked.
What happened?
Look, so what I did in the meantime is I took it off continuous and pushed the talk, and then I reconnected, and I did that a couple of times, and it seems to have somehow worked out. So I have no idea.
Okay.
It doesn't make sense, though. Ben and I were really stumped.
Yeah, it doesn't make sense because, like you said, the triangle, right?
Yeah, man, yeah. I was talking about the triangle of doom here and how, well, two of the magical points on that triangle
meet up.
We just couldn't connect.
I don't know. Look, I've actually been working in IT, and you know, partly with building databases and partly with just like basic IT support, and you'd be surprised how many times just, you know, restarting stuff over and over ends up working.
Have you tried plugging the power in?
Yeah, did you turn it off and on again?
I've had some interesting calls, let's put it like that, in my time. The best one by far of all time that actually I think almost gave me Alzheimer's, I almost did not survive that phone call, was when a client called me up and said if we could change the font in her, we had built an invoicing software for her, so we, you know, just so she could build basic invoices, and she wanted the font change, which is a reasonable request, we could do that. I said no problem. I asked which one she wanted, and she sent me the font file, and I did it, and I said, you know, it's all done, and it took like 2 minutes, so no issue at all. And then she said, will this work on the stuff I've already printed? And just take a moment to appreciate the gravity of that statement. How do you respond to that without making her feel like an idiot? You can't do that. It's like, no.
You have to lie.
Once it's printed on the paper, the ink, the font won't change. That's not how the world works. That was a devastating call. That almost killed me.
She was thinking it was magic. Like, you know, because it's like thaumaturgy or something, you know, she can link it to one thing that it came from the printer, so maybe if she made the change on the printer, it would affect everything that came out of the printer. I don't know, man.
I really have no idea, but it was scary to say the least. And we have had people actually, you know, moving offices and taking their monitors with them, but not their PCs, and then, you know, wondering why it isn't working and stuff like that. That stuff really happens in real life. I think the other time that I almost died, now because we're waiting for everyone to connect, we might as well talk about something. The other time I almost lost my mind was working with an advertising agency who shall remain anonymous at this point, in Copenhagen, a really big one who have some major clients, like a multi-million dollar company, basically, who do advertising for all sorts of international companies. And their whole system, all their invoices, all their orders, all their communication was based on a basic Mac server, just an Apple server in their server room, which ran no backup at all. No kind of backup at all. So if that server dies, all of their business is lost. They can just like turn the key and go home. There's nothing to prove that they've made any money. No one can, like, no tax records or anything. That's really the best thing I've ever tried. We showed up one day and we even discovered it by accident. They're doing something completely different, and we just realized, wait a minute, your whole system is running on the idea that this one server is not going to die. So that was interesting. You learn something doing that sort of work.
But it's actually impressive that those guys have made a company that's actually profitable.
Yeah, their website, the portal that their clients used to make orders from them, was built by an intern they had one day. So I really don't know, but the guy running it was obviously some sort of genius because they had a lot of contracts. Okay, so anyway, now we're going to be moving on to the actual game, and I'll tell more stories another day. It's Virtus Pro and Titan SLTV Star Series Season 10. You're at Room on Fire, and a really big thanks to all of you for tuning in. So happy to see so many of you watching Counter-Strike these days, and obviously a big thanks to all the subscribers. If you want to help us out, and if you want to win stuff, then you can do it at the bottom of the page. There's a Facebook link down there where you can win a team group 240 GB SSD drive. So all you have to do is like the Facebook page, and if you like it this week, you'll be able to win for the next 10 weeks straight as well. So it's just one simple like and you'll be good to go. So definitely go and check that out. It's the picture down there. You have to click it. There's also a link to our YouTube channel and some other stuff down there too that you can check out if you want to support. Then, you know, we sometimes update it. So definitely go and read it. It's just underneath the actual stream. It's worth it. And it's going to be an interesting best of one here, and I'm wondering if we're going to be playing Inferno, because we just saw the map is Inferno, and it's going to be live in 60 seconds, I've been told. So, Semler, since you didn't get a chance to talk at all during the last game, but did you manage to watch the game?
Oh, I had chance. I just took mercy on you all and didn't just cut in randomly whenever I felt like it, right? I mean, I totally could have had like a one-way conversation with Ben the entire time and just talked over you.
But, all right.
I'm thinking. We didn't really see. I mean, it was a bit of a weird situation there. It seemed to me like Titan were just hell bent on doing vanilla things, except that they, you know, Ben said, you know, they shouldn't have had that much trouble doing vanilla things, right? But at the same time, I was thinking this. There was kind of a situation of Titan not really taking their opponent seriously until they were about to get like tied up on into a bit of a tight spot, and then it kind of dawned on them that wait a second, we actually do have to kind of like do things here. So I think VP, I think this is going to be a much better map for both teams. Titan, they can't exactly take VP lightly, and well, VP clearly, you know, obviously they have a bit of a track record with Titan, so this ought to be great. This is going to be what we're looking forward to here.
It definitely will be. I was, you know, casting the Definitive Finals with these two teams. I was really, really shocked by the fact that that VODS.pro won in the way that they did. If I had to put money on
Titan,
on it, I would have put it on Titan at Gfinity.
I would have too, up until the point where, to me, it just seemed like a very odd play from Titan, because I watched that, obviously, and I wasn't there to commentate, lol. But I was watching it, and all I could see really were just very odd mistakes out of Titan as far as like taking Virtus.pro, it seemed at face value, and always kind of expecting, like, just not really trying to think ahead of VP. VP, they kept actually throwing fakes that Titan just kept falling for. It seemed really weird. Like, Titan weren't able to see past, like, two steps, whereas VP were, like, three or four steps ahead. It was a very odd kind of game. Not, you know, rotating before they saw the bomb, that sort of thing, you know? Like, really basic stuff that I wouldn't expect Titan to ever make that kind of mistake they were making in that Grand Finals. So it was a very odd sort of best of three that we saw there between the two. One can hope we see better play from both of them at Gamescom, really.
I'm absolutely sure that we will. And also the fact, I think the map choice as well was really threw me off. But now I think we are about to get ready here. This time we're going to be on Inferno. So a big welcome, of course. Vendetta, who's your team to win this, Titan or Virtus.pro?
I'm on the Virtus.pro train all the way.
Ooh. Okay, then. What about you, Semler?
It's real.
The Frenchmen or the Poles? Or the Belgians, I suppose, too.
Well, okay, so it's roosters, but then what is the Polish national animal? Before I can make a call here, we have to determine like what is the animal of Poland.
I can't
picture a bottle of vodka with legs, so we need to find something else.
Something different. What animals live in Poland?
Well, they don't always necessarily live there to be the national animal, I guess. I think it's actually an eagle as well. And it's not a bald eagle, it's a white-tailed eagle, if I'm not mistaken completely. But some countries have several animals.
Yeah, Firegon is saying that it is an eagle, so we're going to go with that. We'll believe in it. Different kind
eagles
of eagle.
Eagles versus roosters?
Someone's saying a polar bear, which is just...
apparently they have three.
Three different, all right. Bunch of animals.
Yeah, European bison, or bison, white stork, and eagle.
Okay. Alright, so Scream looks on point today. Kenny S, I think, needs more opportunity to use the AWP. I'm going to side with the Roosters tonight.
Now let's get it on here. Kenny going to be falling back behind the archway, and they have a pretty good setup here, but they got to be careful, Titan. Then they get wrapped around. Kenny gets flashed as well, and they're coming in from multiple angles right now. Bialy does go down. Good headshot from Existence, and actually, look at this. It's an over-rotation. Smith, he goes down here. The B-bomb side is lost, and Pasha just gunning him back right now. Down to 25, and this is going to be a bit of an interesting retake coming out here. Pasha takes the one kill. Now he should fall back to safety. Kenny, great headshot. Snacks goes down. The bomb will be planted, I think, but this is now doable for Titan.
This is doable for VP as well, though. Like, the bomb is planted. They're going to be on a timer in Winter 2 on 3, but right now, Titan have to really close the gap. Taz has to stay alive, essentially, and Pasha's going to pick up Existence. This is looking really good right now for VP. Pasha gets a second kill, and Pasha in this position, he is so tough to get rid of. Taz is alive with 50, but Pasha, it's all about him.
He's got the quad kill already. He's looking for the ace. One more click, and he's going to have it. He gets the ace in the pistol round, and Virtus.pro win it. And he was the first guy in the B bomb site. Vendetta, that's ridiculous. He infiltrated the enemy lineup and killed the whole team single-handedly.
Ven, did you just have a flashback to G3 finals right there?
Yeah, that's pretty solid. Pretty solid start. Yeah, that was definitely flashback worthy. Absolutely.
It seems to me like Titan are always taking VP at face value.
Well, what surprised me is that I'm actually not surprised that they rotated so heavily, because VP had four members up in quad, like battling on the steps to the A bomb site for a good portion there of the round. So I'm actually not surprised that the rotations happened. I'm just surprised that virtus.pro got out of it with all five alive.
A good pop flash coming out, and Neo is already gone, and we do have an anti-eco on our hands here, so we'll have to see if virtus.pro can live up to the way we've been hyping them, because we have been saying for the past couple of days that this is one team that's usually really good at dealing with these anti-eco situations, whereas a lot of other teams, I'm talking to you, iBuyPower, have a bit of a reputation of throwing some rounds away, which obviously is something that needs to be adjusted and probably will be adjusted before we get to Gamescom. Great Molotov here. Pasha could have easily picked up that kill.
I was just enjoying that, how sick that was. Because Smith gets forced out, and Pasha's going to be right there waiting for him. Taz with the bomb makes it into Arch, though, and now things get kind of tricky here for Titan. They can't get a kill. Kenny S putting shots into Bialy, but Bialy gets the headshot first. And right now, this is looking like virtus.pro's round yet again. It's two guys alive in pit right now for Titan, and they pretty much have to stay alive, and existence doesn't do it.
A real shame that Kenny couldn't pick up that kill. That looked like that was definitely going to happen. So a little bit of a shame that that he couldn't connect with those bullets, because they were really flash. That flashbang worked out so well. And it's a really standard pop flash out towards Archway as well. Snacks almost goes down here. MBK comes in, trying to see if he can get it done. But it's a 2-on-4, and things are not looking good right now. Smith's looking for an exit kill, and virtus.pro will manage to adjust. And the way it seemed to me, Vendetta, and you have to correct me if I'm wrong here, but it seemed to me like as soon as they lost one guy in Neo over by Archway, they basically slowed it down to a crawl and just realized what was wrong here, what was up.
Yeah, pretty much they gathered up, went together, and made it work. I think you're quite right. Kenyas probably should have had the kill on Bialy and Archway there, and that might have turned things the other way for Titan, but still think virtus.pro play that pretty correctly. Just working together as a big unit, and there's not a lot Titan can do, even with the flashes that they had.
They're going to be moving into the third round here, and they're actually electing similar to go with two pistols. They are not going to rebuy on Neo and Snags. So I'm not sure about that.
This is pretty cool. Again, Titan picks up flash here on existence, and I wouldn't be too surprised if this is going to be like a sudden peak kind of thing from Titan. Actually, it seems like they want to boost up Smith's at the back of sight,
and they fail to actually do that, which is a little bit of a shame, because they have a really good stack here, and this one flashbang, I think you're right, it can make a huge difference. Smoke goes up again, existence, he's going to go with the flash, and then they're pretty all going to peek, but one already goes down, so it's already been significantly weakened. The timing is everything here, and Kenny goes down, and now the flashbang is just much, much, much too late. So, and the knife comes in. No, they're going to get a team kill out of it instead. So instead of the $1,500 bonus, they lose $3,300. And look at Bialy, he's down to $300. That's actually a big misplay coming out from virtus.pro. And I would say generally a really unhealthy sign. Getting knife kills is great fun, but if you start playing around too much, it can really bounce back on you.
It's not something you want to opt for too often. That's definitely true. And couldn't have backfired more for VP than what it did in that situation. I guess the good part is that Bialy already has a weapon, so it's not the end of the world in that sense. It would have been worse if it was Snacks, I think, because he has not bought up yet.
That's a good point. I think, obviously, in the end of the day, it's really not going to matter too much just because VP get the round regardless. They're probably just getting a bit giddy at that point. Bialy's looking to get the job done, but Neo, he's like, hey, we got five guys alive. We're on the B site. Let's go to town with the knife, right? Get that extra $1,500. If he gets the extra $1,500, it's not a bad deal, actually.
Yeah. And actually, I spoke to Shoxy at G3, and he said the whole idea about knifing people is a bit of a kid's mentality, and he very much disapproved of it, so I can kind of understand why, actually, but we'll see over at the... It's going to be Archway here. Sorry, but Banana is going to take down Pasha. That's the first time he dies in the game. Smith's with that kill. Sorry about the screw-up there. I got a little bit confused because my monitor turned off for a second. It's my second monitor, but it still died for just a minute, so hopefully it's going to come back on again. We'll see. 4-on-5 here as Titan get the first kill in the round where they finally have rifles. That's good news.
It's a strong start for them. They just need to play it very solid here. They already have smokes down at mid. Existence is going to take a peek into apartments to get some clear or some information there, see if he spots anybody. Actually manages to tag Neo down to 28, so that's actually really good for Titan. They're kind of shaking VP up. But VP, it seems like they're going to be going for just the smoke round onto A site.
They are slowing it down again. So virtus.pro, as soon as they lose a man, they crawl all over the map to see if they can find a way back into it. And I do like the strategy. Neo hiding over here, going to take down Smith, who did kind of the opposite. It feels like Titans should be the ones who should be able to stay cool, calm, and collective. And instead, they just put on too much aggression. Existence should be careful here. And he spots one guy jumping past. So they know now it's going to be a split B push towards the B bomb site. Scream goes down. Kenny has to stay alive and come up huge here. Taz turns around and waits for the backup, which is actually a great idea. And Kenny might be able to walk out and kill him here. Just sneaking forward. Taz is going to go down. The bomb is planted. But look at the T-Ram. Snacks is here. Ready and waiting. He's poised. He's going to walk up behind them. Snacks. This is absolute genius play. Just watching them already. He's going to wait. He gets the one kill and second one on Ken. And MBK should be picked up any second. This is working out so well. Bailey in the corner takes down Kenny. And now NBK charging in. One on two here. Snacks. He did so much this round. He's going to come in for the next kill. And he will get it as well. Two for Bailey. Two for Snacks. I absolutely adore the way he played that position.
Smart thing to do, actually, waiting in that position. But it could have actually played out pretty horribly for them, seeing how he didn't get the kill on MBK, because Neo went down to MBK with that slight window of time that he was given by Snacks. And I think it was Bialy was the last man standing for them. Okay, yeah, and he had, 19 HP or so as... the other Titan member, I think Kenny S, came running at him.
Now, something that's very, again, virtus.pro-esque is this idea of really putting on pressure when you know your opponent is ecoing. So they're just charging the B bomb site here. They've already traded a little bit, so it's not exactly ideal yet. If they can kill Scream in the background here, they're going to be in a good position. And Molotovs are raining in. Scream has to move, and he picks up a great headshot. Existence trying to land one through, and they're already coming in from Banana as well. Kenny is going to pick up Snacks, and it is actually a 2-on-3 right here. Taz failing the shot, and Pasha has to try and defend in the meantime from so many angles. There's another kill coming in from Taz. He's going to go down, leaving Pasha alone in the corner in a 1-on-2, and he goes for the spray, takes down one. Kenny with the triple is going to retake the round, and virtus.pro lose that anti-eco.
Yep, and they didn't do the same thing they did in their previous anti-eco, which is kind of just simmer down after they lose the entry frag. And take it from there. They kind of just kept on trucking in towards the B bomb site. I think they felt pretty confident in actually taking over it, but this time around they didn't have Snacks to lurk around and pit, and Titan punished them.
2-for-1 early on. Taz does take down Smith, but Kenny with the AWP pushed up all the way down to middle there and just will get the kill easily. So now it's Titan's turn to step up the aggression and maybe try and regain some confidence here. If they can win this round, virtus.pro probably will have to save up for a round before they can really buy, because their economy is a little bit unevenly distributed at this point. Neo and Pasha, what can they do? Semler, I mean, are you still with us?
No, I'm still with you. I'm actually admiring the fact that Titan go for a double op play on Inferno. That's not exactly something we see every day. It's making good use of the two offers that they have. Smith's, and then Kenny, obviously, who's kind of world famous for using the op on Inferno. It's his map, pretty much. But Smith's with a good opportunity in Banana, who takes advantage of it. So I really like this way that Titan has of changing up the pace and really putting virtus.pro on the back foot. Because virtus.pro, you think, okay, well, there's one op, and then Kenny S decides to peek out mid and pick up another guy. That kind of throws you for a loop. But this is a problem now for Existence, seeing as how Neo is going to manage to sneak his way through Arch. It's going to come down to Scream now to cut off Neo before he can get through.
Yeah, and he actually signals that he's there, which I'm not really sure about. Neo's going to run right through the smoke, and Scream halfway flashes himself, still picks up the kill. Could have been pretty dangerous right there. If Scream goes down, then all of a sudden Neo could probably win the round, which would be really scary. 2-on-4, though, and Titan, they do win the round. They lose a couple more people than they wanted to, maybe.
Yeah, but still at this point, a round is a round. They can start getting back into things, and they did force the eco on virtus.pro because they denied a bomb plant, so that's pretty big for them.
Yeah, good news indeed. Now, I think it's on Titan to prove to us that they can play these rounds without losing more than one person, basically. I think they need to come out of a round like this with four or five alive. Losing two or more is what, you know, it's an unhealthy sign for Titan, and something they showed against Overgaming in the last game just here. And already Smith has gone down. Gotta be careful here. Scream being called out, actually down to 33, and they're charging him. They're gonna go for him. Oh, they fall back just in the last second. If they had gone, I'm not sure if they couldn't have killed him then.
Well, doubtful. Smith's getting a little ahead of himself there with the repeak. That gave virtus.pro the opportunity to get a frag and a gun. Now Snax has got an M4A1 to put to use as well. virtus.pro have rotated over to the A site. And I feel a lot of this is going to come down to Kenny S, who's going to take a peek over at Banana and shut down Pasha, but that's the one guy that's like a nip play, basically, from VP. They've left the one guy over on Banana, whereas the four remaining members are working their way towards that A site.
MBK missing a spray, and he's going to go down. Existence now, the only one covering the bomb site, and this bomb will be planted. The question is, are they going to lose the round as well? It is a 3-on-3 now, a 2-on-3, and you must be joking. Kenny coming with the AWP is not the best weapon to retake this, and Scream, he's not even going to go for it. They're just looking for exit kills. They've given up on the round here. This is basically a catastrophe coming out from Titan.
You cursed them, Anders. You didn't even know it, but you cursed them.
You apologize, but I mean, I didn't mean to, but I just, I mean, Vendetta, you're silent here. Are you shaking your head in shame or in I don't know. Are you disappointed? In disappointment?
I'm not angry, I'm just disappointed. To put it that way. No. So I don't know. At a certain point they have to learn, right? So that's kind of the only hopeful thing I can say about it, because they've been losing anti-ecos and easy rounds way too much as of late, and you can't do that versus a team like virtus.pro. virtus.pro saves so much money by winning an eco, and now instead of being in a spot where, you know, they would have had to eco if they lost this round, the upcoming round, they've got people with 4.8k after buy.
They're in a strange position. Snags actually has picked up an AWP and is going to be killing Smiths, and Scream goes down as well. Snags doing an amazing amount of work. MBK will take down Taz, but right now they are at a one-man advantage, and it's really interesting to see Snacks, but he's gonna actually, Neo will pick up the kill on MBK, but over at the B bomb site, it was Kenny coming in with a shot onto Pasha. Now it's a 2-on-3, and they're charging the A bomb site. Existence with a pistol is gonna go down, and the round is almost certainly lost here. Kenny wants to go for it, running into Snacks, has the wrong rifle out for that one. He's gonna go for the AWP, point blank range, misses the shot, and Snacks will die anyway. Kenny trying to escape here, but all they have to do is hold tight, and they can come chase Kenny in a second if they want to.
They certainly have the money for it. We can already see Neo trying to make his way out mid, look for a different angle to change up on. But Kenny smartly has put himself all the way up in T apartment, so he should be able to live through this without too much worry here. Titan are really getting caught off guard by a lot of this virtus.pro aggression. VP, you know, coming right back into it with Snacks and an AWP. That was really cool of them. It's just both of these teams now are trying to basically catch their opponents off guard and trying to get that extra step. And so far, VP are coming out pretty far ahead with 6 rounds.
Yeah, and it's interesting actually to start that we're starting to see some different facets of Snacks as a player, because when we saw him play on Nuke against Titan in the Gfinity Finals, it was actually him in the courtyard with the AWP. So it's kind of cool to see that maybe this player, who's already very good, has even more depth than maybe we thought. I'm intrigued.
Well, there's a good start from Kenny S. He actually does a bit of the JWP and A apartments and gets that entry frag for Titan. So that's a fine start right there for the French Belgians. Now they just kind of have to weather the storm from here on out. Smith with only a pistol on the A side, or on the B side rather, with Scream backing him. It's a little bit tricky. I mean, if they could make this smoke work again, if they could somehow force VP through this smoke, that would be huge. But VP still have a minute on the clock. That's plenty of time for them to make a decision.
And Titan are out of smokes now. That's a really big thing as well. So they are covering this bomb site with two pistols, and the smoke's going to be gone any second, and then they just can't walk through. But Kenny is doing an incredible amount of work right here, taking down Taz over the A bomb site. And if he rotates now, it's going to be huge. Scream is flashed, and they know exactly where he is in this corner. He's going to go down, and Kenny is just, I don't know, 3 seconds too late to the party here. And if he peeks now, Snacks is ready for him. That's going to be the one kill. Kenny's up on the roof, but the bomb is down. It's a 2-on-3. Titan, I mean, what do you think, Ben? They're already running away. I was going to ask you if they should try and go for it, but obviously they've already made up their minds.
MBK manages to pick up an AK as well, so I definitely agree with Titan saving. Even though you're giving virtus.pro 7 rounds, which is obviously not where you want to go, but So they're probably going to win that round either way. They're going to get into good actual plan positions. As you said, Snacks already had a pretty good position aiming towards spawn. So I think it would have been really hard for Titan to retake that without any nades.
Pasha playing a good dangerous game and comes out short. Kenny seems to be firing on absolutely all cylinders, but he's also the only one. They didn't even get that kill at the end there. I mean, Kenny has 14 kills. He has more kills than his entire... two more kills than his entire team combined. Smith, Sixist, and Scream and MBK combined have 12, and he has 14. That is definitely an issue.
Yeah. It's not good enough from the four others. Then again, I guess...
Is anybody else having a flashback to last night?
Edward?
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Well, maybe Edward and Kenny somehow are, I don't know, spiritually linked or something. Because they are carrying a lot in both those games here. Taz does go down. Kenny rushing apartments. And again, you said JW, but that's something we see JW from Fnatic doing quite a bit. And Kenny can definitely do it too. So that's nice to see him get that early kill. Can they build something off it? They have to step up now. Titan lose any more rounds in this first half. It might actually be done. 7 is already a very impressive score for virtus.pro. And Titan, they have to win the next 6 rounds in a row to have a fighting chance, I think, in this game.
That was a really nice pop flash coming out from... the Titan players at B managed to pick off Pasha clean and easy and just get back onto site without losing any members. So that's a big advantage they just gained.
Oh.
That was weird as hell. Snacks actually was looking that way, but he decided not to scope. If he had scoped, he would have just killed Smiths easily. That was really strange.
Yeah, that was a bit odd. Sometimes I guess Smith was wait, or rather Snacks was just waiting a second or two for the smoke to start clearing up. Never gonna know. Kenny's gonna find one shot though, and he should be able to pick up Neo. He goes for the no scope, but the CZ75 will do the job.
And one of those.
There we go. I guess, you know, 3 rounds now for Titan, and that perfect hold for them versus a buy round out of virtus.pro.
Yeah, I think Kenny wanted those extra style points.
Well, I guess Kenny's got to be, like, on fire right now. He's got to be feeling it. You know, once you get into that zone you think you're just invulnerable, you can do whatever you want.
And he pretty much can. He didn't die, so...
He's at 17-0-4 right now.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
Yeah, they've lost 7 rounds and Kenny has survived 3 of them. That's, in itself, a pretty good stat. And he's going to pick off Pasha as well, just easy. He makes it look so effortless. That's a really great opening, and they're going to rotate to leave him here, and... Neo could have easily gone down. Middle with careless peek coming out there. That was not the best way of doing it. And if virtus.pro are smart now, they're just going to say, all right, wherever Kenny is not, that's where we're going.
That's why we're going to the A site. Smiths is already rotated over here as well. It's only going to be Kenny on that B site. And this is an interesting play going to come out here from VP. Just smokes everywhere. They're going to get a quick 1-for-1, but then Neo steps in and picks off Existence. And that was kind of the kill to make the difference here. Scream is now going to try and tap them away. One thing that's holding VP back is that they're stuck in the pit. And there's still a man alive on that site. It's Smith, who's just crouching, hidden. And if he keeps quiet and doesn't make any noise, VP should not be able to get this plant.
And the big problem is now the heavy artillery has been put in play, which is Kenny sends Taz flying. When they wait too long, Kenny gets a chance to hiding in that corner to take them out. So I think actually if virtus.pro had committed to this push and pushed really aggressively, I think they could have maybe had the round. But obviously waiting for Kenny to show up is just not a good idea.
Yeah, I'm actually surprised to see Titan going so aggressively with Kenny down banana. Obviously, he is... your best card, I guess, to do that type of thing with, but both of the backup members from Titan in that scenario were pretty far away, so if Pasha doesn't get picked off, if Kenny S misses that first shot, Kenny S could easily go down with no return from Titan.
Now it's an eco round from the Polish team, so let's see if Titan can get some good kills in here. Great grenade, but Existence does go down. MBK missing a bunch of shots here, but saves a few for Snacks, and one more click onto Taz. Really good management coming out here from MBK, and he's going to pick up the double headshot with the pistol. Absolutely brilliant by Ali and Pasha. Line up for him, and that was a quad kill from MBK. I love that round. Now it's 5-7.
It was actually an ace.
Yeah. Oh, was it a whole ace? Did he get the last one as well?
Yeah.
I mean, the one in between? I didn't even see that.
Got all of them.
Incredible stuff. Well, it's an eco ace, but still, it's worth getting at that point. 13 rounds into the game here, and virtus.pro can buy once more. Kenny and Existence actually picking up the auto sniper, which I think he did once before where it didn't work out so well.
Yeah, versus Overgaming, just in the last game, right?
Yeah.
So he hasn't done it yet in this game, but in the game that was just played on Inferno, Existence did do that, and he got caught in Graveyard with no real impact. So we'll see if it's any better this time around. If VP are going to give him a chance to just camp an angle and hold it. I'm glad to see that NBK is getting those five frags as well, because he has been lagging behind throughout this first half, missing a whole lot of shots. So hopefully, you know, five anti-eco frags, it'll give him a bit more confidence going into these buy rounds.
It means in the first 12 rounds, he only had 3 kills before this. Now he's up to 8, so that's, you're definitely right. He needed some sort of boost of confidence. And NBK's been playing so well last couple of days, so want to see him step it up. I mean, this game is not over yet. virtus.pro have definitely not won. There's still a stretch to go here. Titan, though, they do need to win the last couple of rounds here. The next 3 in a row is what they're looking for. If virtus.pro come back now, it's going to be really, really bad for the French-Belgium team. Now, Kenny, so the archway here, smoke goes up, but he's just going to reposition himself. And this is, once again, a bit of a fake coming up. This has worked a couple of times for virtus.pro, so I don't blame them for trying it. Jumping through the smoke, and Kenny's out of position. Taz is going to get a free entrance. I think Kenny's heard him running up here. Really close to him. Kenny scoped up already. Misses. No, he's going to get the kill. Very nicely done. And now inside the B bomb site, Smith's trying to stay alive. 8 seconds left. The bomb goes down and virtus.pro are coming for them. Smith's will pick up a kill. He's in the back of the site. He's going to go down. And it's a 2-on-3. And this is a horrendous situation for Titan.
They're going to have to manage to get in here fairly quickly here. But Pasha's already waiting for Kenny to take the peek. Kenny gets dropped down to 16 HP immediately. And with 2 remaining members here alive for Titan, basically, they are going to get overwhelmed. Pasha's going to find Kenny S. It's going to be Existence alive in CT, and they just get completely run over. But what was really impressive there is virtus.pro actually managing to get the plant down on B site. No smokes, nothing. They just planted right in front of Smith and Scream. It was almost as if Smith and Scream weren't even there. VP, the pressure that they put on that defense.
I'm wondering if what's happening here is, could this be a theory? Could it be that Existence has actually chained all of them in the LAN house? And they've been boot camping for like 3 days straight, and they haven't, like, they've not even stood up. So now, I mean, they haven't slept for 3 days, because it feels like Titan are just actually malfunctioning almost, except for Kenny. But everyone else seems to be failing.
I guess Kenny knows how to break locks.
Yeah, he's been sneaking out, taking a nap here and there.
That's the nice way to put it. Or maybe he gets off on that sort of thing.
There's nothing wrong with that. I mean,
I'll teach your own. Kenny is definitely, you know, in his comfort zone,
right?
At least. Yeah, Kenny is definitely in his comfort zone right now. It's actually ridiculous how hard he's carrying Titanet right now.
22 kills. I mean, top fragging on virtus.pro is Pasha with 16. They're not even close to Kenny, in spite of virtus.pro right now winning this first half quite a bit. They're going to go for the B-bomb side again. Again, where Kenny is, and that's where you go. And by Ali picking up headshots, Kenny just scrambling to get there, saying, all right, guys, if you can't do it, I'm going to have to try and see if I can win it back once again. Snacks and Kenny running into each other. Kenny misses a shot. AK point blank range, and Kenny, the raid boss, has fallen. And it's almost like you want to call the round at that point. But 2-on-3 retake coming out here. Existence and MBK, they got to win this round back. If they lose this one, they're going to be having to force up in the last round. And it might actually finish 10-5 in favor of virtus.pro. This is, again, a disastrous performance coming out from Titan in this game.
Yeah, the first half is completely falling apart here for Titan. VP are about to get the loot. And Existence gets caught. This is it. Now we look at a 9-5 situation here. A 9-5 situation, and looking at the first half, say, of Titan on their T side versus Overgaming, you're thinking, okay, this is actually pretty damn good here from Titan. But VP are just completely outperforming them here. Titan seem to be caught flat-footed more often than not, and that's not good. It seems like, really, it's just Kenny S. I'm really having flashbacks right now to Na'Vi versus iBuyPower, where Edward just seemed to be on his game, and then the rest of the team kind of just
left behind. Yeah, they're doing things.
Well,
right now,
the rest of the Titan team combined have 23 kills, and Kenny's at 22. So they've got one kill on him if you sort of pool all of them together. So maybe that's the plan. Maybe put everyone in one bomb site, put Kenny in the other, and then just trust that together they can make it work here. Pasha gonna pick down Smiths, and next in line, actually, Pasha will go down to Scream, and MBK hiding here in a good corner, takes down Snags. Now there's a real opportunity that they can make this 9-6 instead, which would still not be good, but definitely much better than 10-5.
I and Kenny is being held back on this A site from the smokes, but they're going to get confirmation now. Scream manages to find the good headshot onto Neo, but Virtus Pro are pushing into this site. They're still here with the bomb, and 45 seconds left. It doesn't seem like they want to let this go, and a very late rotation coming in for here from Kenny. It's all going to be down to Smiths now, who's the last man alive on this site. Kenny just now getting into the party.
Yeah, Kenny does pick up the kill, so Taz 1-on-3, no HP left, is going to go down, and Kenny will pick up the last two kills, a headshot to boot, and it's going to be 9-6. Kenny on 24 kills total. I mean, yeah, the comparison to what Edward was up to in that match is pretty reasonable at this point. So, yeah, bomb gets defused, the fish are going to be safe for another round, and we're going into the second half. So, a quick welcome to anyone who's joining us here. This is Room on Fire. Of course, myself, Anders, and Semler and Mendetta all bringing you some great Counter-Strike content here for the SLTV Star Series. Again, guys, remember to participate in the Facebook raffle at the bottom of the page. There's a link down there over the picture you can click, and you can win a 240 gigabyte SSD drive from Team Group. So do that. It's really easy, and it'll make us happy and our sponsors happy, and that's how everything works anyway. Stick around, follow the channel, and subscribe if you really want to help us out. Of course, we're happy to have you anyway, and this is going to be the second half coming up. Vendetta, what will it take, I think, what it will take for Titan to get back in this game? What order of magnitude are we talking about here?
Oof. Scream needs to play the way he plays versus Overgaming. Kenny S needs to play like he is currently. And MBK has to have one of those games that he occasionally has where he drops a 20 bomb and a half. That's pretty much it. Because Titan in their first half seemed quite similar to what they did versus Overgaming, except now they're playing a much better team than Overgaming, and you see the result. I think that's pretty much what it comes down to.
Oh man, Titan going for three armors, even a Molotov here and a smoke as well, and Snacks just casually walking out, getting the kill, but he's going to be returned upon instantly. And now that's a real problem for Neo. He's going to smoke off and try and buy time here, Flash as well, but they keep charging in, and he's looking for the shot. He's going to go down there. Neo not really making it work, but Hash is very close behind. Actually, this flank might come a bit too quick for what Titan are used to.
Scream is already watching back there, and they can actually make use of the smokes that are already down, but look at this. Posh is actually going to sneak in and catch Scream completely off guard, and now it is a 3-on-3 situation as they are going to manage. Oh, Smith is about to eat a full nade as well, and it doesn't kill him. Only drops him down to 15.
Interesting. Now they're charging around. Existence Call with the grenade out. He's still going to pick up the kill, but he's alone now. 1-on-1 here. Pasha coming in for him, seeing if he can get the kill. Existence just falling back, playing it smartly here. He knows that bomb is down, and Pasha picks up a kit, so buys him a little bit of time, but he's gonna have to move quick, and there are no more grenades left here. He fakes it once, waiting for Existence to peek. He's not doing it, and there's the peek and the headshot as well, and Existence will save Titan, and they win the pistol round, which was an absolute must. If they had lost that, that would have probably been it. And now, Vendetta, counsel us about what is the real danger now.
Anti-ecos, the looming danger of the anti-eco. Hopefully Titan will be able to get it together this time around. And, well, Virtus Pro managed to do it, at least for one of their anti-ecos on the T side, so I think if we just see a slow-paced Titan team not running into stuff, I think they'll be fine.
Pasha's actually picked up a scout in the middle, and he's going to headshot Scream right through the light pole in the middle of the map. That's just so dirty, and Neo's going to pick up a kill trying to run away. Snacks is coming in, spraying through, and BK goes down. It's like clockwork these days. Anti-eco and you lose. It's almost like you just have to not buy and buy these sends yourselves. Maybe that's going to be the answer. Snacks does go down eventually, but Kenny still is on 17 HP, and disaster strikes again.
The power of the CZ. And that is just impressive.
And a scout as well. Ridiculously, they pick up a scout and get the kill.
I mean, it's quite cool to see the scout in play now. 1700 bucks, it's cheap enough. And Bialy, or rather, Posh is going to get one. And then the leaping shot with the CZ at the end. But, like, to see the scout in use so often now in anti-ecos, or in eco rounds, rather, is sick. Not really sure what Titan... Ven, what could have Titan done better there?
Well, Scream could have not re-peaked 500 times alone versus a scout in mid.
That's a good point.
That probably would have helped, but he didn't. And, yeah. I don't know. It just seems like there's no plan behind a lot of things they're doing. Because he was completely alone. I would have been all for re-peaking that scout if they've been two people.
They get the kill on Pasha at least, but a really good grenade here is going to shut down MBK, and Taz should be able to pick up the kill running and gunning, just chasing after him. That's a really good idea. And now it is Existence and Kenny, and a bit of a hiccup there in GoTV, but we're right back into it as they do walk in. Existence goes down, and Kenny is going to be alone in the apartments, and probably not much left to do. He's going to go down. Bailey with a good triple kill, and we're looking at a four-round difference here. Titan could force it up, and maybe they will if they're feeling really anxious here, but if they don't, I'm going to give a bit of a quick shut up, Rennie, in the chat. He's saying they already nerfed the CSET 75 and then a Kappa face. Don't troll the subscribers, Rennie. You know, just don't do it. Yeah, I think true, almost everyone has agreed that that pistol probably should receive a bit of a nerf again.
Yeah, but Anders, they've nerfed it. You know, what, you think Rennie's trolling right now? He's only stating fact.
Standing accuracy, man.
Yeah, he's only stating fact. I mean, it's been a nerf. It's been nerfed.
Can't believe you're teaming up with Rennie.
I gotta take Rennie's back sometimes, man.
When you least suspect it, right? Okay, well, pushing up the middle, it's going to be NBK actually over the apartments going down here, and Taz having a bit of a gunfight with Smith is going to come out on top, spots Kenny as well, so knows that someone is there, Existence, using all his bullets, and when he runs out, they will just take him out. Good shot from Kenny, but he doesn't have a bomb to put down, so he's not even all that effective at the end.
I'm surprised that Bialy's trying to hold this angle. Kenny is going to be coming around from short, however. Kind of musses up his flash, but it actually works.
I think Bialy is timed out.
Okay, that might be it.
Or he's really concerned. Yeah, he's really concerned about the bomb, or he's timed out.
So, yes, we do have horse. You're absolutely right. There it is. Wow, I mean, I really don't know. I think the Titan that we're going to see at Gamescom is going to be leaks from the team that we're seeing right here. And it could be that the practice regime that they have going on, you know, just worrying about other things basically could be a factor, but I'm still concerned to see them make some of these mistakes.
I'm just hoping that we're not going to see that as this at Gamescom.
Oh.
Pretty much that, you know, every team wins their anti-eco at Gamescom, and that's kind of the story of it, because you shouldn't lose as much easy rounds as you do right now. And that goes for a lot of teams. It's not just Titan. It's so many teams.
It really is, tragically. I mean, as we said earlier, probably the team that ends up winning Gamescom might be the team that has figured out the best how to not lose antique rounds. That seems like such a critical factor at this point. Quick shout out to Mike Lilly on Twitter here. That's @MikeLillyCSGO if you guys want to go and follow him. Tweeting a picture of him eating pizza and listening to Room on Fire. So that's definitely great. Looking forward to seeing how Heat are going to be doing in the future.
Well, exactly. Heat and Heat ESG, however you want to put it.
Yeah, whatever.
Mike Lilly is still even at G3. I think what wasn't he like top 5 in stats?
Yeah,
like, he was obscene. So,
I think it was a case of just inches that they didn't make the playoffs as well. I was just I, like two you know, round difference is, or something.
The conclusion I came to, Ben, is clearly at the next LAN, what he needs is somebody to hold over his head a water bottle that just like slowly drips on him. He's clearly getting water dripped on him, pisses him off to the point where he just goes on a rage and just, you know, nukes everybody.
And at the same time as it ignites the fire in him, it also keeps him cool.
Exactly, man. Turns to steam. That's how hot he is.
I like that.
Damn it, before we went off on our little side thing, I had a point to be made, which was that kind of interested right now between both of these teams, because both of these teams currently are in the top 4 of the groups. Titans second with 9-3, and VP fourth with 8-1-4. But both of these teams are within the range of, you know, getting to those LAN finals. So this isn't a game necessarily that Titan can take lightly. I mean, granted, they're ahead right now. They're second place, but you don't necessarily want to be giving up anything here when ESG are right on their tails, 8-1-1, and Na'Vi are 8-0-3. So this is a match that really matters here as far as the group stage is concerned.
I agree, and you know, SLTV, only 4 teams make it to the finals, so you really do need to put in the effort here, because there are some pretty good teams in this season. Again, big thanks for tuning in here, guys. We do have a bit of a pause. Actually, just unpaused, but click the Facebook link at the bottom of the page, and now let's go back into it here. 12-7 scoreline, and Titan have just invested quite heavily into this round. As you can see, they picked up an AWP on Kenny and AKS on everyone else, and they have lost 3 rounds in a row, so they need to start picking it up now, or it might not happen at all.
So we're back into the pause?
Back? Oh no, they paused again. Were they trolling me?
I'm just really impressed with how VP continue to play so well as a unit. it doesn't really seem like any team. When VP, once VP get rolling and have like all four of them, then it's just like the Virtus plow, basically. They just go through any kind of defense because all four of them are just running. And they may lose one guy, they may lose two guys, but then the other two guys behind them pick up the frags and make it happen. It's just like, even if Titan know where the push is coming from, it doesn't seem like Titan are able to stop it. That is on the T side, obviously, but still, CT side, I mean, VP, they've got so many rounds going into the CT side. Even if their CT side wasn't that, you know, was a little lackluster, they've got so many rounds, the lead there is that VP, it's going to be really tough for Titan to come back into this. I don't really see it. I think VP, it's going to come down to, this is VP's match to lose at this point, flat out.
I agree, and they could, I mean, they still could. As we said, Titan, it's, right now it's just all Kenny. Kenny's doing all the work on this Titan team at the moment. So if just a few more people start stepping it up, they can definitely start winning a lot more rounds and then make catch Virtus Pro off guard. We'll have to see right now. It's a 5-round difference. They are pushing up here. Great grenades coming out from Virtus Pro, defending both Molotovs and HE grenades. And another Molotov to follow here. Kenny's going to have to switch up his position. He's being burned alive in that corner. Has to move, but he's not realizing. Down to 35 as he finally managed to extinguish it. But MBK is also going down. Trade it for Neo. So a bit of a mixed start here for both teams.
At least it's the 1v1 trade here, the 1-for-1, but VP have still got solid defense. Once again, are Titan going to be relying on Kenny has to be picking up entries for them? As we already have, I mean, we basically have Titan kind of moving around the map looking to get anything here. Pasha's actually going to peek out at mid after even seeing one guy shooting through that smoke, so he knew at least one person was there, and he's going to peek anyway. So that's kind of given Titan a big opportunity here.
Taz with an important kill spots another one down in the pit. It's by Ali waiting, and Scream is up there looking through, trying to see if he can catch anyone. And they must realize someone is in this pit. It's such a common position. And Taz and Irene might not snatch, just need to get over here pretty quickly, but he don't realize yet. By Ali, oh, the last bullets take out Scream. If he had missed that kill, that would have been a big opening. And now Kenny's down to 13 HP. Grenade is gonna be massive. Kenny is gone, and it's gonna be existence alone. 1-on-3 charges in here. Taz will take him down. But that was a golden grenade right there.
Ben, what do you think is going on here with Titan right now on their T side?
So that round, I actually think they did a lot of things right. Only thing I could possibly, I guess, nudge them for is their execution on A was kind of slow. Obviously, that's down to VP doing a good job smoking off and throwing nades and whatnot. But yeah, it's a hard position to work from when you lose a guy so early in banana.
Oh, MBK! He just barely dodges that.
They gotta be so careful. Oh, Neo goes down! Great angle from existence. He saw that coming somehow. So actually now it's a 2-on-4, even though NBK and Smiths are very low on health, so it could go either way. Pasha's moving up here with an AWP. If they end up pushing him, that could be a big mistake. And Existence has spotted him out already. Gonna try and flash himself out of there. Pasha doesn't hit the shot, so smart play here from Existence. By Ali. Can he pick up Existence at the very least? There we go. The kill is happening, and they can actually still win this round, Virtus Pro, though. They are a man down, and now they're two people down, so that probably seals it.
Yeah, this has to be Titan's round at this point. Pasha, he swapped out for the M4. He's got full HP, and he's got quite a few nades, but 1v3 A site, and Titan with plenty of time to get good afterplant positions, this should all be Titan right here. I don't even want to see Pasha this close. I want to see him backing off and maybe just trying to hold the gun. And he's going to get one at least, so there's the parting shot, and then he just turns tail and runs, you know, so that's the smart move there from VP. Pasha actually managing to do quite a bit of good. And Pasha's actually top fragging right now. He's only one frag behind Kenny with 28, so he is definitely having a solid game.
This one is, I mean, that was a really, really important round from Titan, but Vendetta, because MBK and Smiths were so low at the beginning, did you get a feeling that maybe this could have actually been a round that Titan could have lost very quickly?
I think if Bialy, who was walking up in apps there and caught off existence? If he's able to survive and actually take down Smiths, all of a sudden that's just Virtus Pro on the advantage, really. So it was that close of a round, so Titan got a tiny bit lucky, and also, you know, it's well positioned by Smiths to pull that round off.
Now we're back to square one here for Titan. They lost a lot of people in spite of winning, so they have to keep winning now. This is what we keep saying over and over and over, and we only do it because it's basically true. So we'll see if they can actually string a number of rounds together. I mean, I think they need to win the next three rounds in a row. Then if they lose one, they can still come back into it, but if they lose this one, it's definitely going to be almost over.
It's going to be tough. Scream has taken up his position. He actually had some decent success with this position versus overdrive, and there you go. Not overdrive, but, you know.
Overgaming,
the match
yes.
earlier tonight, overgaming, and Scream finds the headshot on Taz. So that is the start that I want to see from Scream. He's going to go for a second kill as well, picks up Bialy, and now the defense is finally going to close on him on this A site, but the damage is done. And I'd really like to see Titan just speed up here for the B site, and they're doing just that. There's only one man here, and that's Neo, and he's kind of caught out of position already.
Yeah, he flashed his way through, now he's heading right at the edge of the smoke, and they are not seeing him yet. He's going to walk in, get the one kill. If he could have picked up one more, that would have been absolutely massive. But now it's a 2-on-3 retake, and it's going to be really tough here. No bomb plant happening yet. Kenny is putting it down, and the angle is not quite good enough here for Snags. Coming up from Banana, Smiths has already spotted out Pasha. He's going to go for the fight, and Pasha will come up with the kill. So we're in a 2-on-2, and Titan have to hold strong. They got to win this, but Kenny is now alone. MBK goes down, and the poles are closing in. They know pretty much where he is, and they're going to grenade the one corner. Kenny peeks out, not making any noise yet. The bomb's ticking away. Goes down. What? Kenny, he should have picked up that kill. And now they lose a round that they couldn't have afforded to lose. And it's Titan again. I don't know what's happening.
That was just a crazy shot. Crazy flick from Snacks, actually. I was convinced as well that Kenny had that kill eased. And I don't think it was him doing anything bad in that situation. I think that was just a really crazy, crazy turnaround from Snacks.
I see Scoots in the chat with the bat out already. Don't peek. I don't know. From I was looking at Kenny, and from that point of view, it looked like he should have been able to pick up the kill, even with a Galil. Now they are in a very deep hole, and they have no tools to, you know, to somehow get themselves out of it. The ladder is up on the higher ground still, and it's just not working out right now. They have a couple of rifles here, but already taking a lot of damage. They will get the one kill up there in return on Neo's. That's good job, but maybe not good enough. Flash comes in, and Scream actually. Snacks peeks into that, so very nice. Now Pasha's waiting, and he's going to be running in and spraying, but Kenny will finish him. So this is actually a much better round for Titan.
A series of 1v1v1 peeks, basically, from
yes.
Virtus Pro. Essentially, it seemed like they had three guys on the defense there, but they all peeked one at a time. So they were always facing two guys from Titan. Just, unless they had some just sick rifle work, basically some sick aim, VP, in that sort of situation, it doesn't seem like they were going to come out ahead. And VP right now, they're making the smart choice and just kind of hanging back and potentially looking for exits. And, well, Bialy will find Smiths, who is on the hunt. But still, VP have rounds to lose, I think. This is the thing. They aren't going to start sweating because of this one round here. It's not close enough yet for them to feel threatened, I think.
Not just yet, but on a sort of mental level, I always feel, because you're right, this was a series of one-on-one peaks from Virtus Pro, and I think that's a sign of them being too confident, basically, that, you know, they feel the victory is really near, and that's sort of the one thing you really can't afford to do. That would be a big mistake from Virtus Pro to make. It is really near, but you have to think all the time that, you know, you've got to keep fighting for it. And they actually force it up with the remaining members here, buying armor as well.
Well, they do have, that cushion from their round lead to actually do this without being in any imminent danger. So if they can mess this up for Titan, well, then Titan are going to be back to ecoing. So I can definitely see why they would do it.
I'm really scared. And actually, both the rifles are up in the apartment. So Virtus Pro are gambling a little bit that there is going to be some action going on here. Smith walks in and he spots Taz already, and Bialy's going to burn to death. So that's definitely a nice one in the bedroom there. They managed to plant that Molotov right on him, and that's a kill, just a free, basically, a free kill.
Yeah, that was a very cool one as well. We saw that actually against Overgaming as well from Scream. So it's cool to see he's got like these go-to nades that he likes to use to clear out certain parts of this map. And that nade, they go for the corner nade to check noob corner again, Anders. So that's Kenny S right there for you. But then Scream checking out bedroom as well, really using fire, just like VP were using actually earlier on in their T-half. So it's very cool to see how the Molotovs have become incorporated into the strategies for T-side on Inferno, really. You're seeing a lot of teams pick them up pretty frequently now.
Yeah, and that's, you know, something that makes me really happy. And it's obviously a trend that can be, you know, sort of copied to every other map. You just have to spend time looking for the corners where it makes sense to check, and you're going to maybe be in a better position. Neo trying to stay alive, maybe trying to see if he can save a rifle here, but seems unlikely. He's trapped in a weird position, being wrapped around. Kenny's going to take him down with a triple kill, and also dropping 35 kills here in the first 25 rounds or 24 rounds of this game, which is just absolutely absurd. Pasha on the other team trying to carry it up, and it's really Kenny versus Pasha right now. If you look at the scoreboard, that's basically what's going down. Now, virtus.pro has to eco once more, so there's a chance that Titan can bring it back all the way to 11-14 here if they just keep their heads in the game.
Can we just point out the fact that Kenny has 35 frags in 25 rounds?
Yeah.
Like, what is that? Who does that? If he drops a 40 bomb here versus VP, that would be one of the sickest performances we've seen all year. Out of any individual player.
And if they end up
if they end up losing, yeah, how weird is that gonna look?
That's what I was just about to point out as well. That'd be the most disappointing loss for a while, is dropping 40 kills and still not winning the game.
That's the real issue here for Titan as well, because they count on Kenny to get those kills, right? But then when the rest of the team can't follow up on that, that's a real problem for Titan. If they can't follow up on the frags that Kenny is giving them. So their whole strategy practically revolves around Scream and Kenny kind of roaming around looking to get frags. Now Titan, the rest of them need to tighten up their game here and get on top.
Taz is in the corner with the P2000, not really the ideal weapon, I think. C-Set would have been a little bit better here, but that's how it goes. He's going to peek out. Could have taken down Kenny, but a little bit weird hesitation coming out there from Taz. And that's actually going to give Titan the round. But interestingly, again, Kenny and MBK could have both gone down immediately in this round. It would have been a 5-1-3. So again, you know, they get the round, but it's really down to some narrow margins here. And that's something they just can't afford. But they will be taking this round. There will be 11-14 here. And virtus.pro, I mean, I guess they can buy up in the next round. It won't be the most impressive buy, but they'll have the equipment, I'm sure.
Yeah, and actually, I'm not sure if they're going to buy up next round if you're virtus.pro. Simply because, well, at best, Neo and Snacks are going to get Amasis and, you know, a lackluster amount of nades. That's actually a really cute move by Snacks right there. But yeah, they're gonna get. Well, actually, no, never mind. It's my memory serving me wrong. It's the third round they lose in a row, so I'm completely off there.
Well, fair enough. Sometimes, you know, this game has been so back and forth that it's, you know, I'm having a hard time keeping up as well, just because I know they seem to be winning rounds that they shouldn't, losing rounds that they shouldn't. It's very strange right now. But 11-14 is the scoreline. Titan's still very far behind, and They can't make any more mistakes. They gotta keep fighting, keep winning at this point, and maybe they can. Kenny gonna take down Bailly, just barely, but it is enough for a kill. And actually, if they pushed on there, which they can't know, but we know, if they'd been pushing, Taz would have been the only one hiding up here, saving them, and they're gonna go for the apartments instead. Four people, and backup is coming, Neo and Pasha. They gotta move quick, otherwise Taz is gonna be in an awkward position.
And it looks like it's gonna be a balcony play here from Titan. Really cool play. They're going to smoke offshore and just try and overrun the defense. Scream gets caught immediately by Taz, who's still here. And Pasha will catch Smith trying to push out from Boiler. But NBK finally takes out Taz. And it's going to be Neo who manages to get onto that A site in time. And this, at this point, is a sick position for Neo. He should be able to hold from here if he can just hide and play it right. Wait for them to walk up onto the site and get them by surprise. And there you go. Gets NBK. And Kenny is so low that Neo picks him off as well.
And Pasha's coming up.
Existence.
Yeah, he's coming up from behind here, Pasha. There's almost no chance that Existence could know that. So really great movement from the Polish players, and unfortunate for Titan. I like the idea that they pushed up the middle and got the first kill, and then they wrapped back around to second mid up into apartments and went for apps. I actually think that was sort of mentally a really cool mind game coming out from Titan. What do you think, Ben?
I liked it, and I think it was fairly successful as well. They did get out of apps, they just didn't have enough people out of apps, and they didn't really joy guys from quad well enough. But I think it was definitely a nice plan initially from the French team.
Flash in the middle, and Scream is down. Also NBK, he ate a grenade over on the banana, and it's going to be a follow-up grenade here, and it's going to be it actually does almost no damage. Looked like it could have almost killed two people, but this might be the final round here as virtus.pro on match and map point and pushing over towards the banana area again. Neo going to peek out, does go down, and a repeat coming out from Snags. He dies as well. So that's actually the B bomb site now controlled by Titan, and NBK is hiding in the smoke. He's going to be pushing through. Pasha not checking the corner. Right there is going to be NBK getting the kill.
And now we have actually Taz rotating in from the A site towards that B site through CT spawn. He's going to get support from Bialy fairly quickly here, but this is still a feasible round for VP. Everybody is so low on Titan right now, sub 30 HP, That's not going to help things, but NBK with that CZ picks up one, and Bialy is now in a 1v2, and Kenny, he's holding the angle, he's got that AWP, he should be able to pick up this frag.
Yeah, they're letting him past here, but I don't think he's going to realize that Smith is also in this corner, so Bialy is really in an almost unwinnable situation. He has to check so many corners before he can even think about going for the kills. He doesn't have a smoke or anything. Now just walking in, Kenny's scoped up and will take it down. NBK picks up a quad kill in this round, and Titan are now 15-12, and I have to say, I think virtus.pro, this is the second round now they've lost due to basically being way overconfident because they, you know, I think they thought they've already won this, and they haven't. Too much confidence, in my opinion.
Excuse me. Alright. It's a bit, they still have a little bit of room to work with here, but Titan are closing the gap, and that's important. One thing to note is that there is no overtime. If 15-15 happens, it's a tie here between both of these teams, so Titan are fighting for that tie right now. That's the best they can hope to get.
Absolute best. MBK gets the first kill here. Would have been nice with the flashbang in. That would have pretty killed MBK, but it doesn't work out that way. Pasha doing some damage in the middle, but not enough. And very likely we could see not just 15-13 here, but virtus.pro really won't have a lot of money in the upcoming round either. So they have to decide if they want to force it up one more time or if they want to save and wait until it's 14-15 with really buying, which is, I guess, also a risk.
It's scary all on one round, right? This is definitely closer. This is the kind of game that we really wanted to see here. A closely fought game. But VP are just hanging on to the bitter end now as they should be... Well, Titan should be picking this up fairly easily here. Taz has only got 9 HP. He's the only man on that A site, whereas Snax is still rotating in through Arch, but Snax kind of hasn't really made up his mind if he's going to go B or not, and now we see him rotating back. So this should be easy pickings here for Titan. They should be able to get the plant fairly easily and just mop up the rest.
You have to wonder. I mean, MBK, we were sort of wondering because in the first, I think, like, 12 rounds, he'd only killed 3 people, and then he had that one eco ace where he jumped up to 8 kills. Now he's at 21, so if Kenny and NBK had been playing this level all along, it could actually be that Titan could have won this whole game. Not that they've lost it yet, but the best they're fighting for a draw right now. Snax looking for an exit kill. Maybe if he could pick up a rifle and run away, that would be huge right now. And what do you think, Vendetta? Are they going to force it up the next round, virtus.pro?
Well, they definitely could, because as you mentioned, they don't want to really give it up to live very last round, because they have nothing to fall back on. So they could potentially get 2 okay buys, or 1 really good buy. And I think virtus.pro are okay with actually going for 2 okay buys.
Smith gets the last kill in here, and yeah, I mean, why not give yourself an extra chance, maybe? They're going to have, what, 3 FAMASes and 2 rifles if they go for it, but seems like they're gonna not do that. They're going to go for smokes and armor, so they're going to sort of halfway buy up, try and see if they can defend it with this.
I guess that was a big investment for, a big half committal, in my opinion. Because they're still just going to have 1 round now. If they went for a clean eco right now, they would have had a really good buy the next round, and they still would have been able to force up and something similar to this in the last round. So that surprises me.
We'll see. Kenny walking up here, scoped up, has to hit the shot, and he will hit the shot as well. Bialy goes down in the middle. Taz is now running up with a P250, but they're all over the bombsite already, and Taz can't really do anything to change that. He's looking for the kill on the guy who's sort of a little bit out of it here, which is Existence, walking around down towards second mid. Just looking for anything they can get, but MBK is going to catch him. Existence hiding behind the cart right here, and it feels like Neo knows he's going to be jumping up. Neo looking for the headshot, not going to pick it up. So we're looking at a flawless round right now for Titan and a 14-15 scoreline. I have to see if somehow virtus.pro can prevent the draw, because honestly, at this point, if it draws, I think virtus.pro are going to be really disappointed.
And Kenny has one frag away
from the 40.
From 40 bomb.
The 40 bomb. He has to get in this last round. The Roosters, they have to make the comeback. The comeback can be real.
Well,
Kenny,
I mean,
yes, you know, he looks skinny, but he's got broad shoulders. It's all an illusion.
I feel like at this point, whoever wins, it's really hard to celebrate, because if Titan end up drawing now, it means they could have definitely won the whole game if they had just not played that first half so terribly. And if virtus.pro draw, that means they could have definitely won if they just hadn't... I mean, there are 2 rounds where they basically just peaked one at a time because they felt like, We've already won this. Let's just go, guys. And either way, it's Just a very strange game of Counter-Strike so far, but we'll have to see how it all ends up here. The 30th round, guys, there's no overtime it's going to be either. virtus.pro the victory, or it's going to be a weird draw coming in here in this stacked match.
And they have yet to really find a way in here. There is still Taz alive on this A side. He's got support from Bialy as well. But Titan, once again, have spread out throughout mid, throughout the apartments, and they look like they want to close in on this. It's going to be Pasha, who's so close in mid, and he's going to get the first frag. He takes out Kenny. The 40 bomb is not going to happen.
Oh, no. He goes down to Scream right afterwards. So that's a big mistake. Get that man advantage. Just play it safe from there on out. And looks like virtus.pro, they're going to have to be defending this A bomb site with two people in it. Bialy and Taz. Bialy's been playing well so far. They have to stay alive. They need backup, and it's coming as well. Snax is right here. AWP in hand. Takes down Existence. That's a big kill. Taz going to go down to a headshot. Bialy in the pit alone. Sprays down one, but he's being flanked as well, and that's going to be the kill. Now it's a 2-on-2, and this is going to be for the retake now. Snax makes it a 1-on-2, and Scream hasn't got the bomb down. 15 seconds. There's almost no time. They don't have to face him. He's walking out, picking up the bomb. 10 seconds, and now they're closing in. Molotov, and he goes down, and virtus.pro take it in the very last round. Snax with a triple, 16-14. What a game we just saw, and what a lot of mistakes as well, to be frank.
I find it fitting that Snax's AWP is named Boom Shakalaka after a round like that from him.
Maybe, boom. Just maybe. All right, look, guys, we have absolutely no time to waste. The next game is going to be Hellraisers and Na'Vi, and it's coming up very, very soon. So stick with us. We'll go to a quick 5-minute commercial break, and then we'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. This next game is going to be absolutely insane, and you don't want to miss it. So stay tuned, and we will be right back.